That JS4 becomes a platform for the youngins, so to speak. This is Amaya Karve. He's come all the way from IIT Madras. He's an IITian, so whatever. Give it up for him. He loves JavaScript. He keeps putting stuff on keeps putting stuff up on GitHub, and he has a cool project that kind of failed yesterday. No, like the actual project, but you have a video of a thing, which is totally fine. So go for it, Amaya. The stage is all yours. Yeah, it's another robot.
Alright, so before I begin, yeah, it was a hack. I wouldn't call it anywhere close to a near product, and it actually failed yesterday. Half of my circuit is down, but I'll try to compensate it with a real video to make up for it. So, okay, the idea. So the premise is that, you know, robotics in JavaScript is like really coming up. We saw a couple of very nice ones recently. I mean, the quadcopter, that is like really awesome. That could do flips and whatever. So, the premise, again, behind building this was, what if I could have a robo, except it's controlled from my mobile phone, or from my computer, or from a browser for that matter. So, it doesn't need to be any specific device. I could literally plug my device in and control the thing. So, if you look at your, you know, typical devices, say a mobile phone for that matter, or a computer, now any robo, it will have, you know, some inputs coming in, some data exchanges, and then there is the output. Now, the only tangible outputs I have are the screen data, which is more or less useless, and in a lot of them, we have the sound output. So, the idea was that if I can somehow use this sound signal and control a bunch of motors with it. So, I mean, that would be really cool. I just plug my device into my headphone jack, and I'm able to run, you know, a bunch of motors and do things with it. So, I'll begin. So, robo control with the HTML5 Web Audio API. This is me. I'm studying at IIT Madras right now. I'll graduate this summer. That's my email address, my Twitter handle if you want to get in touch. So, the overview. So, what was at least intended to be designed was a robo. The robo consisted of a device that has a browser with HTML5 support. So that could have been my iPad, iPod, phone. I could connect my computer if my robo was big enough. The phone had, you know, the audio cable, which connected to a very minimal circuit that I made, that I could use to actuate the motors and the servos and so on. Now, this HTML5 device, I mean, assuming it has internet connectivity, I have a Wi-Fi network or 2G, 3G, 4G, so on. So this guy was connected with a Node.js server. You can make it real time if you need to, if your motors are sensitive enough. You can use something like socket.io. And then I can have a lot of controllers really connected to the Node server and controlling what the robot does. Actually controlling what the robot does physically through a server. So this is a brief overview of what I'm going to be doing. So I'll talk about the various aspects of this and yeah, I'll just move. So today's talk, let's see, it's the motors, the audio signals, using the Web Audio API. I'll probably not go very deep into that because Jason had a very nice thing about it, all the same. Demo, I'll probably just play a video QA. So the motors, now few basic kinds of motors. I have your regular DC motors. They're the ones with two pins. I just give it a voltage, a DC voltage, it will run. I have servos. So a servo is a special kind of a motor. Now, the idea about a servo is I can control the angle where my servo is going to get to. So, I basically give him a signal that looks like this. Now, this is my voltage signal across time. And I give him pulses. These pulses happen every 20 milliseconds as this thing shows. So, say 50 times every second, I give him pulses like this of width about 1 to 2 milliseconds. It's like that small. It can happen 1,000 times a second if I do that. So, really fast signals. And if I vary this width, now between 1 millisecond to 2 millisecond, I can control the angle where I'm going at. So if it's at 1 millisecond, it will be at one extreme. 2 milliseconds, it will go to the other extreme. So this is how a servo works. Now the audio signals. Now the audio jack for that matter, the 3.5mm jack. If you have any, you know, used up headphones or something, you can cut it open. You'll actually have a jack like that. So typically it's a stereo jack. And stereo jacks will have, you know, the ground that is the biggest one. And the two pins are for the left and the right channels. The signals are electrical signals. They are low. So it's 0.6 on my mobile phone that I checked. A 1 volt amplitude on my, this thing, on my computer. And they are very low power. So it's technically impossible to power a motor or something using this. The three pins again, as I explained. And they are AC coupled. So Quick show of hands, how many of you are like into music or audio editing or maybe electrical engineers out here? Alright, so if you've ever used something called a high pass filter, this is something that would do something similar. So if I have anything that is like somewhat constant, he'll just eliminate that signal. So if you look at the previous slide, if you look at, you know, the kind of signal here, it is constant for this period and constant for this period. So unfortunately, if I try to use it with the audio jack, the signal will be eliminated. I'll just show you things later. But it's a practical limitation of an audio jack. So an example again. So if I have a signal that's a plain wave, that is the first one, there is no change. So you see a pulse in the beginning and the signal is eliminated. This thing is a constantly changing signal, so it remains. So now this guy, this is somewhat similar to the signal that we need. So he just gives you pulses whenever the change is happening. And then for the rest of the times, nothing happens. So this is what we intend, but that is what we are going to get, which is a problem. So this is a problem because, you know, the kind of signal that we need is like that. And we are in trouble here because we can't directly, even if I say I make a file that looks like this, the actual output's not going to be like that. So, yeah, the classic Gandalf thing. Gandalf won't allow it. We can't get the DC signals through. So we've got to do some improvisations to get this done. So we have something called the comparator. Now a comparator is a very simple circuit component. A good way of looking at it is return A is greater than B. So if I have two signals, A and B, whichever signal is greater, he'll return true. I mean, if the signal is, if A is greater, he'll return true. If B is greater, he'll return false. And true corresponds to, say, some static 5 volts. False will correspond to a 0 volt. So how we are going to use this is, I'll just show you. So if I say I have a signal like this, and I set the B value at 0, so A greater than 0 will give you a true pattern like that. And similarly, if I have a, you know, a bunch of sine waves like this over here, and I again set it to, you know, A greater than 0, I'll get a pattern like that, which is what we need. Now, this can be used to power your normal motors, your DC motors. The limitation, of course, is you'll have to run it at half power because, you know, you'll only get it for half the times. And this is the kind of pulse signal that you need to feed to a servo. So, the web audio API, okay, I won't get too deep into it. I'll just try to explain things which might not be, I mean, that obvious. So the web audio API, it's a very high level API. Important point, you can't mess around with the signals at a very low level, at a data level. You can apply generic filters and so on, but you can't really go and say, all right, this is my value, I'm going to change this intensity right now from, say, 5 to 10 or so on. You can load sounds into an array buffer. You can load a lot of audio with modern browsers. And the array buffer can be manipulated. This is the high level things. You can use stuff like filters. Yeah, again, the music people, you'll probably know what filters will be like. And sections of a buffer can be sent to the speaker. So I can say, okay, send whatever is there in my buffer from, say, 1 second to 2 seconds and play that. I can actually send it to the actual speaker sources. What I can also do is I can generate some common patterns, something like a sine wave or a square wave. Some common patterns, you can do this with something called oscillators, which I've used in one of them. So the array buffer, I think this code is precisely almost similar to what Jason put up. So I'll move on with the code. This is something that plays a sound. So it's like really simple. You create a source, you connect your buffer to it, and then you just say play. Play whenever you want to play. When to play argument that I've added here. And scheduling. Now, this is one way to schedule it. So this is like really simple. I'm like every 1,000 seconds, play the tune. Now this is kind of specific because I put my tunes at 1 second each. Of course, you can sort of modify it. And actually, the set interval is not a very great way of doing it because the JavaScript clock lags a lot. So actually, there is a nice way in which this guy tries to sync two clocks. So he can either sync the JavaScript clock and the sync. There's a clock provided by the Web Audio API. Otherwise, you can sync the JavaScript clock and the one that, you know, renders the frame rates. So there are some syncing mechanisms. I've got code up. So I'll show it to you on my GitHub. You can have a look at the code at my GitHub whenever you want to later. It's again a hack. You can please contribute to it if you're going to work on this. The demo. I'm sorry, the demo wouldn't work out. This half of my circuit is fried, so I'd only be able to use the other half of it. But I'll show you a video of how I've, you know, tried to control a servo with the thing. So this guy. So I'm giving him a signal. I'll be, you know, moving it by a special.
Here's the audio jack connected to my computer. It's sort of connected to the circuit. And I have the servo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it rotate by about 15 degrees every few milliseconds and make a full sweep from 0 degrees to 180. So here goes.
So it's rotating by the fixed angle. This angle is controlled. I can have this precise to up to half a degree in rotation. So you have like a real lot of control over here.
So now I'm just going to stop it and make him oscillate a little. So
Never mind the dirty room.
So change the setting. Yeah, here goes.
Yeah.
So I have my circuit.
All right. So I'll move on to the next one. So basically, a few of my friends, they really helped me a lot with this, all the way from, you know, coming up with the initial poster to a little help with the circuits. Vishwanath, Sumit, Abraham, yeah, they're really awesome people. Thank you, guys. Thank you. And questions? Any questions?
Questions?
Anything about the implementation? Anything basic? Anything advanced? I'm fine.
Recruiters, stay away until he graduates. Just saying. Sorry?
Yeah, so you want the GitHub this thing, huh? Yeah, so github.com, Ameya Karve, audio hack. So just check the description file. In fact, I might have it in my browser. Yeah. So there are a couple of these things, files. So is this updated? It's not updated. Oh, never mind. It's not updated on my browser, but when you go in, so there are two demos that I tried to generate. One for a differential drive, that is your normal DC motors, and you control the speeds, you can give it variable speeds. The second was for the servo. Maybe if you go up there, the files are over here. There is one thing called, it'll be in the public directory. Oh, there's no internet, I'm sorry. So there will be a differential drive and a servo drive, couple of JavaScript files. All the code will be in there. I can probably show it to you from my editor or something. Just a minute. I'll show it here. What is this? Show it to me. Anyhow, so that again is a very simple one. So this one I've actually used the oscillator. The other one, the one with the servo drive, I've just put a very simple get audio tags and play it, because there was some problem. I tried to do some very beautiful looking code and fast things, but the guy wasn't fast enough to handle it, and the garbage collector sort of crashed my thing. So supposedly it's a Chromium bug, but hopefully it'll be fixed in a while. So yeah, the thing is still very quirky. Things are coming up. But yeah, again, it's a hack, and I hope we can actually go on with this.
I have a question.
Sure, sure.
So the audio is on, right?
Yeah.
So when you generate the audio signals, do you directly wire up that audio output to the motors directly, or are you passing
that
through?
There's a very small circuit. There's a very minimal circuit. The only components are the comparator. So the comparator is this true-false thing. And the only reason is I need to generate the specified waveform. So the comparator is like a very small chip. It's some 14-pin chip. And the intention was minimum circuitry, but we should be able to get it done. I don't need to buy an Arduino or a Pi for
so
that.
So there is no microcontroller?
No microcontroller, nothing. It's pretty basic.
It's great that you're using a comparator, but do you think the comparator can...
Am I audible? Okay. The comparator that you used, can it serve multiple motors? Is it capable of handling that much amount of current?
So it doesn't serve motors directly. So the servo, for that matter,
yeah.
If I use the servo, the logical input doesn't carry much current.
Okay.
The powering is external to that. So okay. It's imagine it as a switch.
No, not for a servo.
Not for normal motors. For that, you'll have to use something called a motor driver.
Exactly, you need to drive
something. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
For a servo, it should work fine without it.
I was just curious that if you could possibly.
No. It's not possible. So anyone else? All right, fine. Thanks. And if anyone is wanting to contribute, do tell me.